Well, hello, boys and girls. It's when we feel like it o'clock, and I'm Pearl of Wisdom, and you're listening to my NHL Pearls of Wisdom. And we're going to be talking about Mike Hoffman and the St. Louis Blues, as you can tell by the cap-friendly screen here. Cap-friendly, it's the best there, I said it. But before I do, I'd like to remind you that hitting the subscribe button, I will send you a My NHL Pearls of Wisdom necklace, helicoptered to your door by Melissa or Hernandez, Perlocoptered, actually. Wouldn't that be exciting? Nice Perlocopter coming down, sending you a Pearls of Wisdom necklace, a much sought after Pearls of Wisdom necklace. That would be fun, wouldn't it? Yeah, or you can go buy one. You can just go buy one. Go down to any store that sells pearl necklaces and just ask for a pearl necklace and then record that and send it to me. That's for a My NHL Pearls of Wisdom necklace, and they'll send you over to that section, and you can purchase one yourself if you wish. Or you can just hit the subscribe button, and that would, and we'll send one off to you. The liking is good, too, and don't likers. And by the way, thank you for your comments in the comment section. I just did an Ottawa Senators Stepan trade one. Had some very interesting comments from Ottawa Senators fans there. Might want to go check it out. Okay, St. Louis Blues. Now, what did the St. Louis Blues do? We were waiting. We're all waiting to see what Mr. Hoffman was going to do. There was talk about the Vancouver Canucks trying to free up cap space to pick up Mike Hoffman, which I imagine would have been Erickson. But Mr. Hoffman and his agent decided to do something really interesting and sign a PTO, player tryout, the St. Louis Blues. Now, why would a free agent such as Mike Hoffman, a much sought-after fellow like him, do something like that, you might ask? Well, we have an issue with St. Louis. Of course, they don't have the cap space to sign him at the moment, as it looks. But down here, we will see that Mr. Vladimir Tarasenko, and I'm really kicking myself I never came up with this, by the way, when I did my Mike Hoffman videos, why the St. Louis Blues didn't pop into my brain. Because he's going to be out for 5 months, and as of October, so pretty much the whole season. $7.5 million cap hit. Alexander Steen is also on the IR, talking about possible retirement. I don't know why I would do that. I'm sorry. I mean, I love being a cool guy and, you know, doing the honest thing. But $5.7 million, you can stay on the IR and collect another $5.75. Methinks I might do that. Regardless, that's over $10 million. Let me count, do the math. 12, 13, somewhere around there. 12 and a half, 13 million left. So Mr. Hoffman only has to do this PTO, and then when the season starts, voila, he can sign himself a contract. But there's more. There's something else that Mike Hoffman can do here. There's been talk of the Nashville Predators, Columbus Blue Jackets, Vancouver Canucks, freeing up some space, as I already mentioned. Or Columbus may be able to have some space as well, depending on what they signed Dubois for. Nashville has some space. But what Mike Hoffman basically did is said, I'm not waiting around here anymore, guys. If you're going to come for me, better do it now, or I'm going to do this PTO, and off I go. Now, if Nashville does come with the money, what does Mike Hoffman do now? Because, yeah, you're signed to PTO, but what if you get injured? Nobody, they haven't committed anything to you. I'm sure they're not going to say, come do the PTO, and even if you get injured, we'll sign you to a $5 million contract. I find that very highly unlikely. There is a possibility here that a team like Nashville can get off their butt, say, we got $4.5 million cash space, we'll give it to you right now, and that'll protect you as you go through training camp and all of those things like that. And then Mike Hoffman's got to scratch his head a little bit and go, wow, what should I do here? Because you would say, oh, well, you know, he's already committed. They have a verbal commitment that this is going to happen. It's possible. It's possible. But like I said, is St. Louis going to make that verbal commitment happen if he gets injured? What happens if they get injured? Is that really going to be? I find that very highly unlikely. So you could see Mike Hoffman head over to Nashville or another team for that matter that may have some room that is willing to give him the money now. But what Mr. Hoffman has done and his agent, who I don't even know who his agent is, but whoever he is, if I'm a player, I'm really putting him up on the top of my list as agents, because this was a great power move to put the pressure on anybody else out there that might want to sign him. Now, for the St. Louis Blues, how does this work? I have the depth chart of St. Louis Blues here right now. Since Tarasenko won't be able to play, Mike Hoffman can come in. Now, Cap Friendly has Hoffman, O'Reilly, David Perron as the top line here. I find that Ryan O'Reilly is a Selke Award winner, but I don't care who you are. I don't really not want to be put in the situation where I got to be playing with David Perron and Mike Hoffman at the same time as a defensive center. That's asking a lot. I really don't think that's where it would end up here. I think finally Jaden Schwartz is going to get his opportunity to play up on the top left wing. They love him in St. Louis, and for good reason. Great two-way left winger, very underrated player. I think him and O'Reilly will play with Perron. They can both make up for Perron. Perron's reason why I mentioned that is David Perron is not the greatest defense player out there. Mike Hoffman is not known for his defense, to say the least. So then you would put Hoffman, Shen, who is known for his defense, good two-way center. Robert Thomas, who's a young player who's also emerging as one of the better top two-way wingers in the league. By the way, St. Louis Blues in general have a lineup full of those. Zach Sanford, Samuel Blaze, Tyler Bozak, all known for their two-way play. Oscar Sundquist, who I personally think should be playing up the lineup more. Very deep up front. So, yeah, I think that would likely be Hoffman, Shen, and then Robert Thomas. Forward group looks fantastic, which leads us to another thing. We just mentioned they have $13 million in cap space. Apparently, I heard, and this comes from Off the Wall Hockey. I go check them out. Great, fantastic. I just tweeted John from Off the Wall Hockey. Always on point when it comes to rumors and stuff like that or information. He's probably going to do a video on it. He'll let you know. I didn't get to see where he got the information from. That it's going to be a $4.5 million one-year contract for Mike Hoffman. In which case, that gives him room for something that I'm really concerned about when it comes to St. Louis. And that's down here. That's Ville Husso has really not put up huge numbers in the AHL. I think they're probably going to be looking for goaltending. Also, with the leaving of Pietrangelo, I think Corey Krug does work out okay, but I'm still not fond of this bottom. Scandella, Falk, I like Dunn, and they still have to sign Dunn. So somehow they got to get Dunn signed, which I think will cost them about $4 million for 3, something like that, and maybe even get another goaltender. But as far as forwards are concerned, they're set. They may even look at possibly trading now a forward to get another goaltender. I don't know. And anyways, great move by the Hoffman people there, his free agent, to put pressure on anybody out there right now that may be looking towards signing him. For instance, Nashville, who's going to be fighting with St. Louis for a playoff spot, might be somebody that can go, okay, it's time. It's time right now. And an excellent job by St. Louis by putting some confidence in Mike Hoffman and hopefully giving him a little nudge towards signing, where now St. Louis looks like they're back in the game again. They're back to being that cup contender that they have been for quite some time. Kudos to St. Louis for always seeming to be there, always finding a way. They do fantastic out-of-the-box type moves like this, and this is the reason why the St. Louis Blues are always in cup contention, or has been for at least 7 or 8 years. Great move by St. Louis. Great move by Mike Hoffman and his agent, and it's going to be interesting to see where they may go from here. I'm going to be interested to see that. Watch out. We're going to be doing some predictions for each division. I already have one out there. You might want to check. We did the East Division. I did it with the Steel Flyers gang, and I did it with Peyton on the radio, who's going to be part of the Steel Flyers gang. I think I can leak that out there. And go to www.steelflyers.com, because this new year, there's going to be some exciting stuff coming on there. We have some very, very big people in the hockey world going to be supporting in part of this this website. Not to mention, I'll be doing live shows weekly daily, possibly down the road. John from Off the Wall Hockey, Peyton, as I just said, it's going to be absolutely fantastic. That's my full 42. Have a great day, everybody. Lots of love to you.